Over the years, have you seen the community of comics kind of get smaller, get bigger? Like, who's reading comics, I guess? Who's reading Fantagraphics books?
Well, I don't know who's reading Fantagraphics books. I mean, I have an idea in my head who I think is reading them, but I don't know if it bears any resemblance to reality. I mean, I think you have the hardcore comics fans. I mean, you have people who really know comics, love comics, know something about the history of comics, and appreciate the medium for what it is. And then I think you have a whole bunch of other people, you know, that runs a spectrum. People who don't know a lot about comics but are intrigued by the medium. People who read comics specifically based on the subject matter of the particular comics they're reading. And this is borne out by the fact that, I mean, Mao's sells very well every year, and it's not because it's a comic, it's because it's about the Holocaust. I mean, it happens to be a comic about the Holocaust. So you have maybe the appeal is the uniqueness of the comic, but the other major appeal is because it's about the Holocaust, and that's what the buyer wants to read. He's interested in reading about that particular moment in history. So I think a lot of comics sell because of the subject matter, not because they're comics. In fact, I think that's probably the biggest problem we face with the comics medium right now, is that a lot of people don't read comics because of the medium, the way that they go see a movie because of the medium. You know, people go see a movie no matter what because it's a movie. I mean, they just want to see that flickering light on the screen. So I think you have a spectrum of people who are reading comics now. I mean, as opposed to the 1980s, when it was almost entirely people who were obsessed with the medium. I mean, now it's expanded from that.
Now, do you think, so you talked a little bit about, you know, people went in and wanted to read about the Holocaust.
Mm-hmm.
But, I mean, I don't know, when I look at, like, if I go into a comic shop these days, there's not a lot of diversity of content. It's mostly, we've got the superhero stuff, we have some of the more independent stuff, but
mm-hmm.
I don't know, from my perspective, it looks like there's not much diversity.
Well, I don't go into comic shops, so I think you're probably right. Is there diversity in comics? Well, you know, I mean, there's not. Well, I don't follow mainstream comics anymore. I assume that there's a modicum of diversity. I mean, you have, you know, superhero comics, you have Vertigo style comics. You know, they're probably all more or less genre based. I'm not sure I look at the diversity so much as I look at the individual qualities of comics. I mean, if you look deeply enough, you will find diversity. But of course, you have to look. But isn't that like everything else? I mean, it's like, you know, films. I mean, I look at the. I don't see films in theaters as much as I did. But occasionally, I'll go through all the films. Say, is there a film I want to see? 95% of it is just complete shit. You know, I don't want to go anywhere near. And I can't even imagine like why this stuff is created, who sees it, why it's made, how it sells tickets. To me, it's just, you know, all just garbage. And I think that's probably true of comics too. I mean, it's probably true of everything. So you really have to work to find the good material. And once you do that, then I think you will find diversity, because you'll find unique artists, all of whom have their own point of view, you know, and their own vision and their own stylistic approach. So I think if you dig deeply enough, you will. But you know, the comic stores are probably a microcosm of pop culture. You know, I don't pay close attention to television, but I assume most of it's garbage.
I hear most of it is.
Yeah. And, you know, what you hear mostly about is, you know, the better stuff, you know, the Homeland or whatever. But yeah. Most of it is just plowing through, you know, the options is just a terrifying and demoralizing experience.
Very true.
As it is in comics.
Thanks for watching. Click here to subscribe.